wire strippers. These are wire cutters. These are tin snips. This is all my life. I had regular repairs when I wired my house. Built and wired, you know, I wired, I heated, put the heating in. Anything I could do to save money when I built my house. So, that's all I had. And today I still use tin snips to strip wire. I grew up in West Seneca. I'm the youngest, second youngest of eight. But my mother's favorite, of course. Graduated from West Seneca West High School, went to Alfred College, Broadmoor Technology, got my degrees, got all my certifications. And the biggest thing I learned in college is I didn't want to be on the campus. So I hated it, but I had to get my degrees. 99, I had a kind of a change of life. At 37, I got married. At 41, I had a big change of life. I had my son. At 43, I had my daughter. Some people buy cars, I had kids. I've been with TRS Heating and Air Conditioning for 31 years, been in business, I'm the first employee there. One thing we do, one thing I talk about, and I'll send this around, for every builder, the codes have changed. For every builder, we have to do a manual J, a manual D, and ductwork. I don't know how many pages this is. But we do this for every builder. In Clarence, if you want to remodel your basement, you need one of these also for the inspectors. I'll just throw this around so you guys can kind of glance at it. Nobody's going to know what it is. Maybe Chuck will know. But that's something we have to do. It's part of the codes that we do. One of the things we do at TRS Heating and Air Conditioning, we do all new homes. We do about 700 new homes a year. Myself, my department, I run the sales department. Do anywhere between $1 million to $1.5 million in sales. We've grown from maybe 5 employees to we have 32 employees now. We run 4 service techs. I have 3 crews that install the furnaces and air conditioning. You guys think I'm nuts, but January, February, March, I install a ton of air conditioning. Get people ready for the season. I send out specials to people. We don't advertise. Our advertiser is right here. I have 30 salespeople that are in this office besides myself and the other salesperson I have. One of the things about our company, we're an honest company. I've rented houses, and I've had people ask me, were boilers or systems, do I need a new heating system? Do I don't need a new heating system? I'll sit and I'll explain what you need. I don't consider myself a salesperson. I consider myself more an educator. I had one sales training that I went to. They thought I was nuts because I don't ask for a contract right there. I don't ask for the job right there. I'll educate you. I'll leave you a contract, and I'll let you guys make the decisions. Do I get every job? No, but I get more than I lose. That's just my way of doing things. I don't think it's fair to go into a house and not get a materialist for what I need and not sell you what you need. I'm not going to try and upsell you. I'm salary. I wouldn't do sales any other way. I don't have to sell your job. My kids don't need shoes. You know, I don't have to upsell anything. I'll education, and I'll sell you what you need and what you want. I'll give you some decisions to make. You can make the decision. You can talk it over. Myself, how I want to be sold to. I hate pressure people. I hate pushing stuff down people's throat. I talk everything over with my wife, as Jeff will probably allude to. We're tough people to sell to, and you know I want to make my own decision, and that's how I let people make it. The letter we've gotten. I met that gentleman. I sat in his house at his kitchen table with him and his wife. I kind of looked at his wall. I seen that he was in the service. I thanked him through his service. 4 hours later, I'm walking out of the guy's house. He has the information he needs to make a choice. I do that all the time. I've been down to Guanda when they had the floods. It was a senior lady. I was holding her hand. And she was crying, telling me her basement's flooded. She lost everything. What can I do? I gave her a really, really good price on her furnace. And I put in all the ductwork free. I rolled up my sleeves. And I went and did it for her. You know, basically lost money on a job. But we made $400 or $500 jobs. Made a senior a great, you know, great customer. We took care of her. I couldn't help her clean her basement out, but I helped her other ways. And we're all about doing that. We do a lot of Energy Star program. When I get into the Energy Star program, it's for everybody. I get a lot of lower income people. I've taken been to a house where cockroaches were crawling over my shoes. Lady was there, she had a black and white TV, she had her TV, she had her Bible, that's all she had nothing. It didn't cover smoke detectors through her whole house. I put smoke detectors through her whole house so I could sleep at night. That's stuff that we do at our company. The owner, he's right along with me. I don't even have to ask him stuff like that. People that need help, we're there to help. Middle of snowstorms, our service manager, Jeff, we had a generator down. Last snowstorm we had, 1 o'clock in the morning, the people were without power. He was out there to get their generator. We truly care about our customers. I truly care that I do the job right. I've walked away from jobs because the people, someone else with 30 years experience, had told them that this is what they need and they believed them. I have over 30 years experience. I showed them what they needed. I didn't tell them right. I didn't explain it to them right. They went the wrong way. I would rather walk away than do the wrong job. I totally believe in the new technology, the newer boilers that are out there. They're 97% efficient. I just did a job for a church. When we are doing the boilers, we should have done last year. They have a million BTUs. When I measured, it took about 4 hours to go through the whole building. They need 600,000 BTUs. That's what I'm putting in. And I put two boilers in instead of one. The lowest area that they need, like a room like this, they have 15 feet of base, it puts out 11,000 BTUs. That's all I need. So the boiler I put in is a modulating. The room is only going to, the boiler's going to come on at its lowest fire instead of having that million BTUs for all the time. There's a lot of the new homes are getting tighter, the codes are getting crazier. A lot of indoor air pollution now, you're finding. Emily talks about it, all the chemicals in the house. Well, when your house is tight, and you're not changing the air, that's part of it. In our design, you'll see where we change the air 6 times an hour on this one. Bring in fresh air, we exhaust stale air. A lot of times we'll do it through the bath fan. Instead of having a bath fan, we'll have an air-to-air exchanger that exhausts through the bath fan, so you don't even know it's running. The technology today, Chuck had mentioned to me today about a guy that got an air conditioner, he got a real big air conditioner for his house, and it's great. His house cools down in a minute. It shuts off. He's going to save so much money. Well, when he starts replacing windows, when he's not dehumidifying, he might as well live in a cave. It's wrong. He probably paid too much for the system. He's going to be paying too much for his utilities. Heating and cooling systems nowadays are so much different than our parents. For their kids, we put our gloves there, it's nice and warm. They were cold outside to come. It was hot. Now they're warm air furnaces. They're not hot air furnaces now. And I explain that to people. I take the time to explain it. Our guys, we have a lot of longevity with our guys. Yeah, guys, I'm 31 years. I'm the first employee there. Think about 31 years in the same place. Who's been married that long? It's tough. It's a great place to work. Our guys have been there. I've got guys that have been working with me 20 years now, 15, 10, 12, 5, 6. I'm always looking for young guys too. So if you guys know young guys that are looking for trade, we're always looking for younger people to bring on. As overall business owners are in a business, it's tough to find young kids that want to work. We find them, we take care of them, we train them. Most of the guys are trained either by me or somebody that I have trained. Our sales staff, there's me and Chuck in my girl in the office. Some people will call her secretary, I call her my co-worker. We work great together. You can call our office, ask for Kim. She answers, she'll answer the questions. If we don't know it, we'll get back to it. I'm not afraid to also tell you I don't know something, but I will give the answer for it. Computerized. My boss does the Vandal J's, the stuff. Me and computers don't get along. I'm the type that, first of all, it's good.
We're going to change it.
So, who do you know that's looking for a great referral would be for me is somebody that wants to educate themselves, needs a heating system, or wants their system repaired, or their generator, give my card, Paul Robertson, TLC here.